Good morning, students. Welcome to the new semester, and it's good to have you here in this platform. I want to take this opportunity probably to go through an introductory topic, or rather a session of just trying to set objectives for this class. And this is going to also help us to know what is expected of us in this semester. I'll be taking you through BIT 3201, which is programming with .NET framework. In other places, they call this visual programming. So it's whereby we are able to use .NET framework, which is a product of Microsoft, to be able to create applications. Specifically, our focus will be on one side, we'll be looking at what we call desktop applications, but also web-based applications, web service, web portals, and just try to understand a few concepts in there that are quite practical, to be honest with you. So I'll be taking you through this session just to help you understand what we are expecting in this semester. And I hope out of that we will be able to learn together and move on together. Let me check how I can be able to So I'm just hoping we can be able to see this. So this is just a bit of my just introduction about myself. This is my name, Daniel Njeru. I am a facilitator of learning at ZTech University, based in Thika Road campus, TRC campus. This is my email address, just in case you need to get in touch with me, daniel.jero@ztech.ac.ke. This is my phone number, but also that's the unit that I am taking you through. I will just go through the first, this introduction, putting the house in order, just trying to understand what is expected of us. Helping us to put measures or structure within our class that can help us to run smoothly in this semester. We require a class help, and I know once we are able to meet together, I'll be able to, or rather, we'll be able to facilitate this. But once you are able to get this recording, please try and get my number. If you have a WhatsApp group, please. Give me a heads up on WhatsApp on how I can be able to join your WhatsApp group, because that also helps us to have a seamless communication. We'll need group formation, which will be groups of a minimum three, max a minimum two, maximum three. Probably this may be adjusted depending on the number that we have, and that will help us to do the assignments that we will be doing in this class. Some of the key objectives that we seek to achieve in this class is upon satisfactory completion of this course, students will be able to design, implement window-based and web-based programs in Visual Studio, which is just an integrated development environment. Very robust from Microsoft, and we'll just be able to get to learn a few concepts in there. We'll be able to develop simple graphical user interfaces. We'll be able to understand the concepts of object-oriented programming, and I believe for 3.2 students in BSc IT at ZTech University, You must have by now covered a couple of object-oriented programming, example being Java. So I am expecting that you must have covered some of those, and so we'll be refreshing this in a new angle altogether. The other thing is use control structures such as sequence, selection, iteration, and some of those you've been able to look at them in other programming languages. You must have talked about for loop, you must have talked about while loop, do while, you must have talked about decision structures, decision control structures, such as switch case and many other. And so we'll be refreshing that from a new angle. Of course, our language that we want to dive into in this space is going to be C#, and that's what we're going to be using. We'll talk about class libraries, and this, like I'm saying, in other languages, you must have looked at them, but just to understand what is it that we can gather from this class, or just class libraries that are available in .NET framework, especially just bearing the fact that .NET framework is not a platform for just one programming language. In fact, we can be able to integrate more than 30 programming languages within .NET framework. Some of them are already available there, but some of them you just need some few to add some few libraries and you have it or up and running. Use of functions and subroutines is something else that we'll be able to look at. But also we desire that we can be able to understand concepts of distributable visual programming with .NET applications. This class is meant to be 3 hours in every week. And I will be structuring this in a way that we can be able to have a one-on-one interaction through Big Blue Button. But also we will have times for discussions, times for forums where we can do some discussions, times for us to do our own assignments and some learning activities. I am also considering to use GitHub for especially for our practicals, where we can be able to collaborate. You can send your codes in there and I can be able to evaluate that. Teaching methodology, this is really changing, and probably some of the things that I need to add here is that we'll have class lectures have now been translated to online collaborative learning, which is what we are doing right now. Case analysis, of course, practical sessions will be very, very key. In this. So my job is basically to provide you with an environment where you as a student can be able to actively learn skills and knowledge necessary to meet the objectives that we have set, but also provide an in-depth understanding of .NET framework. And in this case, I'm assuming that you don't have any prior knowledge in this area. And so I will help you to dive from basic rising those skills up and seeing what we can be able to gather. I will always be available during class sessions. So in case you need to get in touch with me, just for us, because I mean, I have other classes. So if you look for me during other times, you may actually miss me because I have a class with other students. But I'll be available during class hours, and that is this time. And so anytime that you need any consultation, you can get in touch with me in this time, and I will be able to provide you with some support in that sense. The other thing that I need to say is I'm expecting that you will be able to participate in lectures and lectures. In this case, I mean just the online collaborative sessions. I will be taking attendance based on how you attend live presentation such as this on Big Blue Button for every session. I will expect that you participate in teaching sessions, but also forums, discussion forums, and I will actually grade you. Part of the grading will come out of that. I will expect that you beat all the set deadlines, and I'll talk about that as I talk about evaluations. Participate in group work, in continuous assessment, but also in continuous assessment and also in CATS and final exam. But also I hope that we can be able to recognize common courtesies. That is, for example, having technology can be a bit challenging. You need to mute your mic when you are not speaking. You need to ensure that there are not two devices that are connected within the same room, because that can cause some echoes. You need to ensure that your dress code is official when you're attending face-to-face or online collaboration learning. So that if you are to put your camera on, then you may not be in a way that compromises ethical issues that relate to us as students. Then also, just those common courtesies that we all know, and those things that can actually make this learning process seamless. So just make sure communication, ensure that you do communication during hours, all those things. Yeah. Sometimes I ask students, what sort of student are you? And let me just pay attention to what all of us would endeavor, which is to be an A student. And the definition of an A student for me is a person who asks and answers their own questions, using outside resources if necessary, but also people that are able to develop a critical and appreciative understanding of the textbooks, the resources that we are providing for learning, the lectures, but also eventually be able to work creatively with what they have learned. So endeavor to go beyond just understanding few things, concepts here and there, basics, but move far beyond that, because that is what an excellent student would look like. Just a minute and then I'll be right back. Yeah, so what we are saying is also in terms of course references, there are some books, some of them can be available as e-copies online, but also in our e-library. But I must say also that we have quite a lot of resources online that can understand the .NET framework, and some of those resources are commendable for you to use them. Assignments, CATS, and final exam. These are just about how it looks like. And like I said, online collaborations will constitute to your grade for this semester. Assignments, CAT in terms of MCQs, that is multiple choice questions. Final exam, all that is what is going to be evaluation for us in this semester. I need to say that late submission rule is one of my rule for the classes, which says 10% off per day with a grace period of 1 week. And that means that if I give you an assignment, and many of the assignments of course will be here on this platform other than some of those practical sessions, but if I give you an assignment, I will expect that assignment is done and submitted on time. And if that doesn't happen, I'll give you a grace period of 1 week. And if you don't submit within a week, then I will deduct 10% off from your grade every day that passes without submission of that assignment. And this is just to keep you on check, not really to harass anyone, but to keep you on check so that you can be able to meet the objectives, but also so that you can facilitate us to also meet the objectives. These are some of the things that we desire to understand. So starting with just the basic understanding of the framework, the development, the integrated development environment that we use. What are the components? What are some of those languages that exist in that platform? And how can we be able to use them? What are the functionalities that exist in that? What are the features? About base class libraries, talk about common language specification, common language runtime. What are those features and what do they mean to us, even as developers? And that will form pretty much part of just the foundation that can help us to understand how to use that platform. Of course, we'll go to the language, the syntax, so understanding what are the data types, and what are the data types? What are the variables? How can we create variables? What are the data types that we can use? What are the functions that exist? What are the decision control structures that exist? What are the procedures? How can we create procedures? How can we use them? Subroutines, arrays, all those things are going to form part of our discussion. We'll have sit-in cut. In this case, it's just an online MCQ cut, which you will sit and do. But also we'll look at just designing, object-oriented design, so designing classes, object-oriented programming concepts, advanced object-oriented programming concepts, and just getting to understand some of those concepts that relate to Visual Basic, but also relate to C#. Mostly our focus is actually going to be on C# in this class. So this, of course, the other part that is very key in this class, I must say, is Windows Form application development. And this is creating interfaces that are so friendly. You must have looked at system analysis and design as a course in this, at some point you must have looked at such a unit. And so there are some of those concepts that you may have learned in system analysis and design that we would want also to implement. So things like minimalism, for example, which is a concept in designing interfaces or designing input and output interfaces, are concepts that we would desire to use here. So how can we be able to develop, how can we be able to create Windows Forms that are interactive, that help the users to actually be able to enter data, but users also can be able to visualize data. Those are key things that we will look at. So building also web applications is a key area, and I'm hoping that our time will allow us to dive a little bit deeper in this area. So understanding web form application development, creating web services, and this is using also ASP.NET, that is Active Server Pages. Then also part of this is, of course, the database aspect of the applications that we are developing. So how can we link a particular interface that we have created with a database? And this we can look at Microsoft Access and MySQL, those two. Is just an understanding to help us understand how can we create an interface that interacts with a particular database on the back end, and you can be able to enter data from the front end, and that data is stored on the back end of within a particular database, and that will be very, very key. Then almost the last part of this class is also now how can we package applications. For example, we can create a desktop application that has an interface and a database. Can we be able to package that into an executable file that, as you know, you can pick with a flash drive and use it and install within a particular machine somewhere and function. So deployment of applications is key as far as this course is concerned. And so that will form part of our discussion in this class. I am willing to listen to our suggestions that can edify learning in this semester. Remember, this is pretty much new for many of us here. But also I must admit that in many times we have used learning, we have had an element of face-to-face class interaction. And so this being a practical class, then we may want to ask ourselves, how can we edify learning? And so suggestions, options that can help us to make this seamless, to make this more interactive, to make this enjoyable, those are suggestions that I would want to welcome us to share. And so you're welcome to give your views. I'll create a discussion forum or under this course or under this sheet that you can be able to share your thoughts around what is your expectations for this class, but also that you can be able to help me to understand, is there something else that we may want to add into this class that can edify learning, that can make learning more interactive, more enjoyable, especially now that we are using a blended learning approach. And so welcome to the new semester. Looking forward to a great time together. Once we are back, we'll be able to streamline or just align ourselves and our objectives, and then we'll set what we need to achieve for the semester. And after that, we will be able to move on. But allow me to, it's custom for me to begin any given class with a word of prayer. And like I've said this in many other classes, is because I believe strongly that, yes, for us to sail through a semester, there are many, many reasons that can actually deviate our attention from learning. And so in many cases, you might find issues to do with school fees are affecting students, issues to do with health, issues to do with our family or dear ones are affecting us. And that can be one or two reasons that can help us, that can make us not to have a smooth learning process in this semester. And so I desire always to commit each one of us and myself to God, so that our semester is seamless and that we can be able to learn together. And so I'll pray, and then that will form part of our today's discussion for this class. Please leave your comments and on the discussion forum that I will create in this class. Let me know your thoughts, some of those things that you desire that you can achieve. Your questions can come as well, but also you can use my email or my phone number to get in touch with me in case you need any help. Let me pray, and then I will end this session. Dear God, we commit ourselves to you. This great time that you have given us this morning, we are glad to be alive, and thank you for protecting us in such a trying time that we have had. And we want to ask that you will keep us safe in this semester. We pray that you protect each one of us and our family and our dear ones, especially in this trying time of the novel pandemic, COVID-19 pandemic. We ask that our families and our dear ones will be protected. We pray for provisions for each and every one of the students, that they will be provided for all their needs, O Lord. And we ask that you give us perfect health through the semester, that you bless us. We pray for ZTEC University and ask that you will bless us. You bless the management from the VC, from the board, from the Dean's Council, to the management, to the department, to every one of us, that you bless us and you continue to grow this vision for the glory and honor of your name. So we thank you and we look forward to a great semester, that you will give us perfect health and you give us an amazing time together with the students. I pray these things, believing and trusting in your name. Amen. Thank you and see you in the semester.